Hi everyone. Next we discuss about crystal oscillator. The crystal oscillator something look like this. Okay. So this is we are calling as a something crystal slab, and it has holding. So we can call this portion as a holding plate. Usually, crystal oscillator are not naturally made, and it is not manufactured synthetically. Also, it is actually exhibit from physioelectric effect. What is this physioelectric effect means? It is under the influence of mechanical pressure, the crystal vibrates, the voltage gets generated across the opposite face of the crystal, and it is nothing but subjected to the AC voltage, it vibrates, causing mechanical distortion in the crystal shape. Every crystal has its own different frequency depending upon cut. Here we can take one particular frequency which can make as a oscillation to that. Next we will discuss about the equivalent circuit or AC equivalent circuit of the crystal. That means how it is look like and what is the inside of this crystal. So in this crystal we have, if you give something AC signal, so we can make like this. This is the plate, this is the crystal slab connected like that. This can be written as usual. Here it is nothing but AC. So in this we have something like this portion we are calling as a CM, and here this is R and again L, and we have C. Okay, so it is nothing but RLC circuit parallel with the CM and connected to the this portion. This is known as equivalent circuit of the your crystal. So here, here capacitance existing due to the two metal plate. We have one metal plate here, another metal plate here. Due to this, actually the capacitance is exit by dielectric light of crystal slab. It is called as a mounting capacitance. Okay, mounting capacitance we can call as a CM, or we can call as a, which is actually generated due to the these two the metal slab. Okay, so that is CM. And extra we have, when it is vibrating, there are internal friction losses which are denoted as resistance R. Okay, so we can call R as a resistance, while the mass of the crystal, which is indication of the inertia, is represented by the inductance. So that is called as a L. And in vibration condition it is having some stiffness which is represented as a capacitor. So usually when crystal vibrating, it has mainly three properties. Each property is represented by one by one. If it is any friction losses, so this is represented as a your resistance. Okay, and if any stiffness is present, okay, that is usually we are calling as a capacitance. And if any inertia represent, then we are calling that one as a inductance. So for these, all the properties happen when the crystal is vibrating. For that each one we are defining in a our RLC. So that is RLC, and this CM what we understood. Now we can draw the particular circuit diagram for crystal oscillator. So as usual we know that any oscillator is, first we have amplifier, then we have feedback network, and then it is connected to the again amplifier. Same technique we'll use. We'll use here as usual our voltage divider bias as a transistor. So that technique only we can use. First we will take transistor. As usual we know that here this is emitter and this is collector, RE, and we have anyway CE is there, and we have resistance R1 and R2, and it is connected to ground, and we have something called as a, already we discussed what happened to the RC, so we are calling this one as a RFC. And anyway we have the coupling capacitor CC2, and here coupling capacitor CC1. Okay, this is all about the, and here we are connecting VCC. Okay, this is all about the amplifier circuit look like. Now we have making that as a crystal, so we can take as a feedback network. Feedback network is nothing but a crystal, so use like that. Okay, this is how the crystal look like. So it is connected to here. So this portion is known as your feedback network, and this portion is known as amplifier. Only difference is we are using the feedback network as a one crystal. So crystal is something like that. Okay, the middle one box, it is called crystal slab and holding. Okay, and also you can write equivalent circuit of this one, like CM RLC also holds good. From this we can write the frequency. Like actually here we have two type of resonance possible. One is we called as a series resonance, another one is we are calling as a parallel resonance. So series resonance frequency we will call as a FS, and parallel resonance frequency we can call as a FP. So series resonance frequency we can call FS. So what happens, this one 1 divided by 2 pi root LC. So it will take as a this L and C, R is ignoring. So this particular portion we are calling as a series resonance frequency. Okay, where in the parallel resonance, if you are talking about, so we are taking the same equation, but the thing is we have to use the capacitance as a parallel. So we can use C equivalent is equal to, we have two capacitance, one is C, one is M, CM and C. So we can take something like that. It is actually series connection CM and C, but series connection in the capacitance formula like CM into C divided by CM plus C. Okay, this is how we can write the frequency of the crystal. So usually we can call FP is equal to nothing but 1 divided by 2 pi root L C equivalent. So C equivalent is nothing but this. In the series only F is equal to 1 divided by 2 pi L. Next we discuss about the problem of crystal oscillator. A crystal has following parameter, L is equal to 3 Henry and C is equal to 0.05 picofarad and resistor is given 2K and CM is equal to 10 picofarad. What are series and parallel resonance of frequency of crystal? So in the solution we can first do the what is series resonant. So a series resonant, if you want to take, so go with the formula what we have here. Fs is equal to, so Fs is equal to, we got 1 divided by 2 pi root LC. So in this case anyway 1 divided by 2 pi as it is root. L is we got 3 Henry, L is equal to 3 Henry. So it is 3 into, we have C is equal to 0.05 picofarad. So go with the 0.05 picofarad. Okay. So simplify this and find out what is Fs. You will get as a something called as a Fs is equal to 410.88 kilohertz. Similar way, go for the FP. So remember, when you are going for series or parallel, here series we are taking this portion. Okay, this is the series portion, and if you are taking parallel, you are taking all these stuff. Anyway, resistor portion we are not taking for any of the series or parallel here. So whatever R2K is given, it is negligible and ignorable. Go for the FP. So your FP become 1 divided by 2 pi, as it is here 2 pi root L C equivalent. So here first you have to find what is C equivalent. C equivalent is equal to, you are getting CM into C divided by CM plus C, where CM is given 10 picofarad. So 10 into 10 to the power of minus 12 into 0.05 into 10 to the power of minus 12 divided by, similar way, 10 into 10 to the power of minus 12 plus 0.05 into 10 to the power of minus 12. So the answer of the C equivalent we will get as a something called 0.0498 picofarad. Okay, this one apply to your C equivalent. So you will get as a 1 divided by 2 pi root, L is 3 Henry into C equivalent is 0.0498 pico. Okay, you will get the answer. So find out what is your FP. So you are getting FP is equal to something like 411.71 kilohertz. The thing you have to remember, in the crystal oscillator, the frequency of crystal is very high compared to the other what we have done. Sometime we will get 2 mega also, 3 mega, like that also possible in the crystal. Next we will discuss about one more oscillator called Miller crystal oscillator. So Miller crystal oscillator is actually higher version of your crystal oscillator. So basic topology we can take like this. where we are using one FET. So this portion we can call as a something called amplifier. So we are using transistor as an amplifier, and this is coupling capacitor, and this is the actual the feedback network of the your Miller crystal. So Miller crystal means we have anywhere crystal oscillator we discussed crystal is there. With this crystal we are using series of capacitance and parallel to the inductance. So this particular topology is known as Miller topology. So it is the next version of crystal oscillator. The aim of this particular is it is work in the electromechanical applications, and the desired cutoff frequency can be obtained as required. So in this application, oscillator is a signal generated by crystal and output is obtained from tank circuit load. The inductance L1, we can call this one as a L1, and capacitance C1 of the tank circuit. So this portion is nothing but feedback network, or we can call as a tank circuit. Okay. This tank circuit is adjustable to desired resonant frequency. In general, inductor is chosen to have fixed value. So L1 is fixed and C1 we are usually we can vary. So we can give different C1 value according to the desired resonant frequency generator. Now the higher version of the or improved version of the Miller crystal we can write using FET diagram. So that is as shown below. In this using FET diagram we are using as usual voltage divider bias. This is your drain, this is your source and gate. So R1, R2 as it is, and this is CC1 and this is CC2, everything. But the thing changes is instead of RD resistance we are using one is C1 and this is variable capacitor, one more is L1. So this variable capacitor is known as varactor. This is used as a voltage controlled capacitor. Okay, this is also called as a voltage controlled capacitor. So in this is main commonly used that the oscillation we can control the voltage whatever required for the amplifier gain. After that we are given as it is the feedback as a crystal oscillator. So this is used for the control the frequency, and we are making as a shaping of the sinusoidal which is connected between CC2 and CC1. How already we know that coupling capacitor. The difference of crystal and Miller crystal, it is crystal we use usually transistor, but Miller crystal we are using FET. So another one difference, we are using the stuff in the RD resistance or whatever we are used in BJT RFC, we are using one more tank circuit known as capacitor and inductor. So where the capacitor C1 is variable, it is also called as a varactor, and L1 is fixed. So from this we can find the desired, or we can generate the desired resonant frequency.